Hello everyone, and it's a pleasure to be back again talking to all of you on another very, very important topic, improving selling skills. Whether we like it or not, we're all selling every day. If you're in a sales role, of course you're selling, but even if you're not in a sales role, you're always selling your company, your brand, or even your own personal brand. So today I want to give you all certain things that you can do to ace selling and become the top salesperson in your organization or in your role or even as a person. So let's get started. Firstly, I want to talk about what are the critical mistakes that people do in sales. The first thing that I've seen is making the sale as a typical transaction. Somebody wants to buy something, you just want to sell something, you give them a price, they say yes or no. This is the first mistake I've seen where it just becomes a typical transaction between the person and the customer. The second mistake that I see people doing is not listening to customer. It reminds me of my own example when I went and met a customer for the first time in another country. The first half hour I was just blurting out the different things that we can offer. And later the customer told me he's not even looking for what I was talking about. That made me feel embarrassed. The final one is just sharing the features and benefits non-stop without closing the loop of the previous point I made about understanding. So if you can understand the customer better, if you're not making it a transaction, if you're not just selling the features and benefits, already you're going to avoid critical mistakes that people make. Now let's come to what do customers really want and why would they take a sale from you? The first one is if you're offering a very, very competitive product, if the price is of their desire, if it is very cheap, they would go and probably want to buy that from you. The second reason why they would buy from you is if the dire need, they really want something and you have it, they will buy it from you. These are two important things why customers would buy from you. But of course, the most important reason why customers buy from you is if you have a strong relationship and trust built with the customer. These two aspects I want you to keep in mind. And now let's go to what are the three things that you can do to make sure that you can close every sale that you're trying to do. And before I go into that, let me just quickly remind you all, don't forget to subscribe and press the notification button on my channel. So let's get started on that. What are the three things you can do to make sure that you can be a successful salesperson? First of all, establish a strong customer relationship management with the customer. It's very easy to say what I said. Now you may be wondering, how do I do this if I'm going to meet a customer for the first time? When you walk into a customer's office physically, or now it's a bit virtual, so it's a little bit difficult. So we'll talk about a little bit of the physical part first, and I'll give you some ideas on the virtual part as well. When you're connecting with the customer in a physical basis, when you walk into his or her office, just notice what you see around the office. Do you see photos of sports personalities? Do you see photos of God photos? Do you see family photos? Do you see flowers? Do you see any cues that can help you to tell you a little bit more about the customer's personality? Use that and start talking about that to create an icebreaker. It's very, very important that you have a strong icebreaker before you start talking about your product and services and your company. If you don't do that, it becomes a transaction and then it becomes all about the price. Another thing you can do is, once you start establishing the initial connect, try to ask the customer his hobbies, what does he do on weekends, so you can start connecting. You know, if he likes football, for example, you can speak to him during the football season or the cricket season. If he likes movies, talk about movies that has been going on, the current situation, and that will be a connect with them as well. So try and find different things that you can establish an ongoing strong bond. Remembering customers' birthdays, wishing them for events, festivals, another very small thing you can do. I still remember one of my top performing salesperson, whenever there's a customer's birthday, all he would do is go and drop a cake and not talk about business. Later on, he will go and talk about business. So this is how some of the small things you can do to establish a strong customer relationship. Now in a virtual environment, you can probably not look around the office too much because you're seeing through a camera, but before you start talking business, tell them about yourself, tell them your background, your family, and ask them similar questions as well, in a very small leading way. This will again help you to connect even on a virtual perspective. I've tried this and it definitely works. The next important thing is for you to be very sincere and honest with the customer. Do not lie during a sales conversation just to get the order. If the customer wants a particular thing, you'll only know it if you ask them. So if you want to be honest and genuine, the most important skill is to listen and understand the customer's needs very well. Initially, start asking them questions about what are they looking for? What are the current challenges that they're facing? What kind of customer base they have? What kind of business plans they have? Get deeper to understand the customer's business and then see what could be the relevant product you can offer without just pushing something that you want them to buy. Let's say, for example, the customer wants to store food items that doesn't have to be kept outside. Like he wants a cold storage. Now, you may want to sell a freezer, which is more expensive, but all he may need is a fridge. So don't try and push a freezer if there is no requirement for a freezer. And if you sell it in the right way, and even if it's a cheaper product, he will appreciate that you saved money for him and next time he will come back to you. And because you have a strong relationship with the customer, he has developed a trust with you because of the great customer relationship you have done, he will believe what you say as well. You have to make sure that you don't misuse the development of trust that you've done with him and use it only for the right reasons. Finally, post-sales relationship with the customer. After you sell something, don't just walk away and forget about him forever or him or her. You got to always connect back with the customer, asking them, how was the product? Are they using it? Any problems? What do they like about it? Do they want to talk about it to their friends and family? Would they recommend this product to their friends? The post-order management is what I call is so crucial for your long-term customer relationship. I hope you will follow these three things and ace being a top salesperson in your organization or in your life. And thank you all again for listening to me. Till I see you all again in the next video, stay fit, stay positive, but don't forget, keep chasing obscene success. Thank you so much.